question, and in today's session we will learn about Planck quantum of action and photoelectric effect of line separation by using interference filter. Order code is 21225093.2. So now further we will learn about its apparatus which are required for the experiment. So this is DC regulated power supply of plus minus 5 volt. This is toggle switch to turn on and turn off. This is basically toggle switch to change the polarity to plus 5 and minus 5 volt. This is digital display. These are output port and this is voltage control knob. This is basically a 10 turn potentiometer. Now, second apparatus is current amplifier. This is its turn on and turn off toggle switch. This is its digital display. And this is its band switch to measure lower value. And this is basically input port. So now, this is halogen power supply. This is of 12 volt and 35 watt. This is its toggle switch. And here we will connect the cords, and these are connecting cords. Now this is vacuum photo cell with housing and mount and lens to focus light on the cell. So this is halogen light source, and there are different types of interference filter. So basically there are six types of filters. So this is first filter, which is of blue, which is of wavelength 465 to 475 nm. This is orange filter, which is of wavelength 575 to 585 nm. This is red filter of 625 and 635 nm. This is green filter of 515 and 525 nm. This is yellow light filter of 505 and 515 nm. And this is yellow light filter, yellow dark light filter, which is of 545 and 555 nm. So now first of all, before proceeding to our experiment, you have to set the photo cell and halogen light source 25 cm apart from each other. Then after that we will make the connections with photo cell, DC regulated power supply and current amplifier. So for that, first of all you have to connect this output to input of photo cell. Then after that you have to connect the output to current amplifier. Then we have to connect the input of current amplifier to photo cell. So this is our all connection for current amplifier, DC regulated power supply and photo cell. So now we will make the connections for halogen lamp power supply and halogen light source. So now we have to connect these connecting cords to light source and then it's another end to another end of light source. So this is our whole connection. So now this is the whole setup for our experiment. So now we will perform the experiment with blue interference filter. So now we have to insert this blue interference filter in the tube assembly of photo cell. Then after that we will switch on the power supply. Remember it, we have to set all the knobs at their minimum position. Then after this we have to switch on the halogen power supply. And as you can see that light of halogen supply has grown. So through this knob you can increase the intensity. So you can see that intensity of light is increasing. Then after this we have to change the polarity to plus 5 volt. And then increase the voltage about to about 4 to 5 volt. Slowly you have to increase the voltage. So you will see that current will also starts increasing as we are increasing the voltage. So it's now about 3.05. So when it comes about 4.5 or 4.3, so till then you have to increase the voltage, so it's 3.98. So I'm setting the voltage at 4.37 volts. So now after that you have to change the polarity to -5 volt. Then after that you have to set the band switch to a definite polarity. Then after that you have to deaccelerate this voltage until the current reading goes to zero. So as you can see that I am decreasing the voltage. So slowly you have to do this process. You can also turn this knob also. So as you can see that at 1.09 volt the current turns to zero. So now after that we have to set the current amplifier band switch. As you can see that there are certain variations in current. Then we have to deaccelerate the voltage. So you have to decrease this voltage until the current turns to zero. Then after that you have to change the band switch of current amplifier knob. So as you can see that there is certain current reading. Then after that you have to deaccelerate this voltage control knob. So then reduce the voltage till the current turns to zero. So as you can see at 0.94 volt the current turns to zero. So as you can see in the table which is provided in our user manual, so for that the range of voltage should be between 0.09 to 0.93. so our voltage is about 0.94. so for blue interfilter our voltage is about 0.94. So now after that we will switch it to green filter. So this is green filter. Now we will place the green filter in this tube of photocell. So now we will check the voltage for green filter. The process is also same for green filter, that you have to turn on all the supply. So you can increase the intensity by this intensity knob. So as I have increased the intensity, then after that you have to switch on the knob of DC regulated power supply. Set it to +5 volt and then start increasing the voltage for about 4 to 5 volt. So as I am increasing the voltage till 4 to 5 volt. So as you can see I have set the voltage to 4.23 volt. Then after that I'll change the polarity to T to -5 volt. So then after that we have to set the current amplifier knob, so that our current will start increasing. Then after that we have to deaccelerate the voltage until current turns to zero. So you can see at 0.63 volt
current turns to zero.
So as you can see in the table, for green filter the voltage range varies from 0.62 to 0.68 and our range is 0.63 volt. So this is for green filter. Then you have to calculate the photoelectric energy for this. So basically this is our table, which we have, first of all we have mentioned for all the filters, then their wavelength, then the frequency of light, then this we have to calculate, and this is for photoelectric energy. Now you can repeat the same procedure with yellow light also. This is yellow light filter. So now we will place the yellow light filter on photocell tube. So this is, we have inserted our filter. So the process is same, that we have to switch on the power supply and make certain changes in DC regulated power supply and current amplifier. So now I have already switched on the power supply. Then first of all we have to set it to 5 volt. Then after that we have to increase the voltage to about 4 to 5 volt. Slowly you have to do this process. So increase the voltage slowly. So as you can see that I have set the voltage to about 4.35 volt. Then after that you have to switch the polarity. Then you have to set the current amplifier so that current value is displayed. So as you can see that current value is coming. So now after that we have to deaccelerate the voltage. So you can see that at 0.64 volt current turns to zero. So we have checked for blue, green and light yellow. Light yellow, for light yellow the average value varies from 0.68 and our voltage is also about 0.68. So you can try the same procedure with different type kind of filter, such as dark yellow, orange and red also. As you can see that we have find the average voltage for blue, green and light yellow. Similarly, you can try this with different filters such as red, orange and dark yellow. So in this way, we have the wavelength for different filters. This is the frequency of light. These are the range of voltage. These are average range. And after that, you have to calculate the photoelectric energy, which is E into V naught, where E is the charge of electron. So you can find this by that formula. So after that we have to plot the frequency of filter versus photoelectric electron energy. So as you can see that this is the graph of energy versus frequency, and this graph is basically a straight line graph. So this shows that as the frequency is increasing, then energy is also increasing. So after that you can find by its intercept and by the slope of line you can find the Planck constant. So for that formula is, this is for Planck constant, that is H is equal to E del V S upon del V. So H is equal to 1.602 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 into 0.91 upon 2.2 into 10 raised to the power minus 14. So Planck constant is 6.26 into 10 raised to the power minus 34 joule per second. So here we conclude our today's session. So for further query, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited, Jaipur. And you can also refer to our user manual. So this is all about today's session. Thank you for watching.